Good morning, everyone. I'm going to give you an overview of my project. My name is Jakub, and I'm working on realizing the potential of carbon composites in compression. So I'm going to give you a brief introduction, talk about material properties, then talk about failure and what we can do in terms of failure. So just bear in mind, everything we talk about here is compression. So when we think about high-performance materials, we have this idea that they're linear up until failure. Now, this is not the case. The non-linearity in carbon is quite well documented. So you can see here, this is real test data from several different tests, that we have a strong indication of non-linearity. And if I blow this up, it follows similar curves. So the modulus will drop as the compressive strain increases. Now, that's compression again. So what will happen if we go to really high strains? We have indications when testing single fibers that this is what happens. So we have a really high strain of 15% compared to our typical laminates of 1.2%. And we have this metallic-like plateau in here. So why do our composite fails at 1.2 when the strain to failure is 15 of the fiber? Now, clearly it's not a fiber property, and our matrices are typically, I don't know, 10% strain, probably higher. So it's a structural phenomenon, that's called shear instability. Now, the way shear instability works is shown in this picture. So we have a composite with initially misaligned fibers. We compress it. This misalignment will create shear stress. Now, shear stress will create shear strain, and that will increase the misalignment. However, now there's a higher misalignment that increases the shear stress again. So the strain increases, so the misalignment increases, so on and so forth. We'll reach equilibrium eventually. Now, if we increase the load here, this equilibrium will be lost at some point. That will create an instability and lead to failure. So we can model this behavior just to check what we can do about it. So when we model it, we know that matrix properties will govern the strength, and also that initial angle, alpha, that will have an impact as well. So when we model it, we get a curve like this. So this is our input resin. So shear strain, shear stress, pretty typical for an epoxy, 60 megapascals maximum stress, and 1 gigapascal, 1 gigapascal modulus. And this is the output. So higher angle is lower stress, is lower strength. And obviously lower angle is higher strength. Now, what happens if we change the resin properties? So this is just higher moduli. And we can see that the strength increases significantly at low angles. Now, with these, so this is just for the matrix modulus. We can also play with the strength. We can play with how what happens around here, if it's got a long plateau, if it's got a shorter plateau. So we can model this. And where do we want to go from there? We want to create a test in order to assess the nonlinearity of the material. So we want to push it to high strains, quantify that nonlinearity that we observe, then measure it, and then validate our models. So we want to know that we're predicting the right thing. And then we want to move to new materials, so materials that will suppress that mechanism, give us higher strengths. So this work is part of Hyperduct in collaboration with Imperial College. Both the program and myself are sponsored by the EPSRC, and I'll be happy to answer any questions.